Welcome to another Gourmet Fish and Info Short. I'm your host, David Murray. And on today's short, we're going to be creating another appetizer, but we're going to duplicate the appetizer from episode one, which was a seared scallop and shrimp dish served with a citrus butter sauce. But the difference in this week and last week is the process that we go through to get from point A to plating. That is a cooking method known as sous vide. So before we can get our sous vide short out to our planetary population, we gotta take care of a little bit of business. So don't we start by rolling the open. Before we get started, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the little notification button. That'll let you know exactly when we upload anything new to the channel. And please like the video and leave any comments you'd like. Hey, let's talk about our grocery lists. We're gonna need a couple of scallops. We're gonna need a couple of medium-sized shrimp, some salt and pepper. Now we've added two more ingredients, fresh thyme and a clove of thinly sliced garlic. And we're gonna need limes and lemons. We're gonna need a nice white wine that you enjoy to drink, butter, and heavy cream. So let's get started on our sous vide process. Now sous vide translates into under vacuum, and that's what we're gonna do. Is we're taking us a vacuum seal bag. You can use a Ziploc as long as you get all the air out of it, which you can do that by putting all the ingredients in, putting it into a water bath, and then sealing it. So let's get to our vacuum portion of sous vide. So we're gonna need two salt and pepper, our scallops and our shrimp. Don't need a lot on there, just like so. Now we're gonna take our bag, just like this, and we're gonna place our scallops in first, just like so. We don't want to stack any of the shrimp or scallops on each other. We want them to try to cook as evenly as possible. I'm going to come in here. Now we got a couple of pads of butter, just like so. You can add those however you want. It doesn't matter where they go. Now we're going to take our garlic, add that. We're going to take our, you know what we're going to do? We're going to take, whoa, how about that catch? How about that? We're gonna add our citrus, which is our lemon and lime, like this. And I'm gonna come in with my fresh thyme, and I'm going to add that on top, just like so. Now, we're gonna come in with our vacuum system, like so. I'm gonna lock it in place, then we're going to hit the moist control because some liquid will be coming out as we pull all the air out. And then we can hit back and seal. All right, now we've got everything sealed up into a nice little packet of yumminess. So we've got our precision cooker, easy for me to say, set at 128 degrees. Our water bath is 128 degrees and it will stay constant throughout our cooking time. And that's what makes sous vide so unique. What we're trying to do is to bring the temperature of our food up to its surrounding area, and then that's as hot as it will get. You can't overcook it. Now we're going to place our little sous vide package into our water bath. We let it sit for 26 minutes. We're gonna take it out, and then we will finish it up, plate it up, and have a little snack. Well, through the magic of editing, 26 minutes has elapsed, and we have our sous vide shrimp and scallops. Now, let's open this up, take a look at what we have here. These nice scissors we got going on, just like so. Now what we have, here are scallops. Don't look very appealing right now, do they? But they're done, they're spongy. They're not overcooked. Look at our shrimp, they're done. They're not overcooked, just like so. Now, how do we make this look like they've been seared? Well, what we're gonna do is we are going to use a torch. This is kind of just a butane torch. And we are going to dry our scallops off, just like so. That will help them sear a little quicker. I'll do the same thing with our shrimp. And I'm gonna definitely have to wash this towel. So, here we go. We're gonna break open, I think, the torch. Here we are. Look at that, we are pulling out some of the great caramelization of the built-in sugars that are inherent in these scallops. Well, just like so. Come over to this one, do the same thing. Oh man, oh, you ought to smell it. Unbelievable. Ooh, snack, crackle, pop. Hit these one more time. Just like so. There we are. Got our nice little, we got our nice little torch sear going. Now, let's grab our plate, like so. We have, and this is kind of neat. We've already prepared our butter sauce, and that's the neat thing about this sauce is you can prepare it, easy for me to say, ahead of time. You can keep it in a little thermos, which will keep it warmer, the metal insulated glasses that we all seem to have on the boat works just as fine. I put mine in a squirt bottle. So I'm gonna come in here, just like so. Give a little bit of a shake. I'm gonna take my scallop, put them here. Take this guy, place it here. Take my shrimp, voila, just like so. Now, since I've got my sauce in a squeeze bottle, I'm just gonna add a little bit on top, just like so. Now we're gonna finish this off with a little bit of lime zest, just like so. Oh man, there you go, that is it. That is another way, another method to make our seared scallops, seared shrimp, and our citrus butter sauce. So, I hope y'all enjoyed the video. Give it a shot. Again, sous vide has so many possibilities. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Hit that like button if you like the video. Leave your comments, please. And don't forget to hit the notification bell, and you'll know exactly when we upload anything new to our channel. So, until next week, God bless, and we'll see you then.